making some as I sell these in my business for Easter. So we're going to, I'm going to bring you over here and I'm going to let you watch me make them, and I will post a recipe in the show more section. You're not going to get the exact recipe I'm using today because it's my secret recipe, but I will give you a basic recipe that will work and you can try to make bath bombs yourself. Okay. We are going to be, I have mixed in here already 4 cups of baking soda, 3 cups of citric acid. In here I have cocoa butter chips, and this is what they look like before you melt them. You get them on eBay, right here. This is what they look like, and you melt them in the microwave. That's how I do it anyway. I also used coconut oil because coconut oil is very good on the skin. And I just buy this at Walmart, and I just put, you know, a good tablespoon and mix it up in here and melt it. I also use kukui nut oil. It's from Hawaii. It's body oil. And I just squirt a little bit in there. I also use vitamin E, and I squirt just a little bit in there. Vitamin E is very good for your skin and your hair. And polysorbate 80. That helps to bind your coloring that I'll be using, my mica powders, and the oils and the water together in the bath. And I've already added that into my oils, and I've melted my oils. So I'm going to mix my oils with a spatula here just to make sure that they're incorporated. And I'm going to be adding white kaolin clay. It's always tricky getting these bags open. I added about 1.5 scoops of this. White kaolin clay by Crafter's Choice. I'm going to add 1 scoopful of cornstarch. And I'm going to be adding in, I purchased some pure Epsom salt therapeutic soak. It relieves aches and pains. I'm going to be adding about 1.5 cups. And you'll get clumps in this because it absorbs humidity from the air, or just, you know what I mean, from the different temperatures that the bag shipped in at the store. So there's 1 cup. You're going to want to break up the clumps. And they're easy to break up, just squeeze them in your fist. And there's 1/2 cup. So we got 1.5 cups of that. Let's clean up my area a little bit. I'll be putting gloves on after I feel the wet texture of the bath bomb mixture. You really need to run your fingers through it. You want it to be like wet sand, not waterlogged sand, but wet sand. Now we're gonna mix this. I'm gonna check to make sure that you guys can see everything. Okay, now I'm gonna start adding my oil. And you're going to want to do this a little at a time. I'm going to use the smaller scoop because you really want to add just a tiny bit at a time, not to activate the ingredients that are in here. Okay. also want to have a spray bottle of rubbing alcohol. 90 something proof. Stir this at the bottom to make sure I'm getting everything incorporated. When it starts to clump, that's when you know that you're getting the right consistency for your bath bomb mixture. If it doesn't clump, it means you don't have enough liquid. I'm just going to mix really good with a spatula, get all bottom ingredients pulled up to the top. Essential oils. I use fragrance oils and essential oils, but today I'm just going to use essential oils, and I'm going to divide my batter because I want different fragrances for, you know, the different bowls. I'm going to put 2 cups in this one and 2 cups in the other one. For the pause, I want to grab another bowl, and these are my mica colors. I'm going to be using a little bit of yellow, not much. I wanted a soft yellow. I'm going to be using a soft blue and a soft violet color. The gloves. I'm going to pan over here to make sure that you can see. Sorry for the jumpy camera. And see if I can zoom in more for you. Okay. My gloves on. Okay. Add some lemon essential oil, add 2 cups full, mix, mix, mix. Eucalyptus with the lemon as well, because I think that would make a good refreshing. Ooh, it smells wonderful. I really like the eucalyptus with the lemon. Okay, now I'm going to add just a tiny amount of mica. Just gonna put a little bit like that, dump it in there. Mix, 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 because I want it to be a real soft yellow. I don't want it to be a dark, dark yellow, because we're doing this for Easter after all. Okay. smidgen more. Oh, that smells so good. And there's the yellow. I just want a pastel yellow. I don't want a really dark yellow. Get that out of the way. Now, we're gonna mix in some sweet light violet coloring. Muscle going into making bath bombs. There is a knack for it. They can be kind of tricky. It took me quite a while to get the hang of it because mine kept falling apart, and even once in a while, still now, you'll get one or two that you go to put it on the cookie sheet and it just crumbles, or a part of it crumbles. So don't take it personal, like, I can't do this. Don't beat yourself up. You can do it. You just got to keep at it, keep at it, keep at it. You'll finally, one day something will click and you'll be like, oh, and then you get it. Okay, and then we're going to use a real soft pearl green, it says, but it looks like a really light blue. These colors will be so pretty for Easter. Mix, mix, mix. And I still have to put fragrance here and here. Or essential oils. I'm not using fragrance oils today. I'm gonna need more of that. Light on, maybe it'll help you see better. Here's the real light violet lilac color. This is the soft yellow. Here's the soft greeny blue right here. You can see that. Okay, what do we want to make the soft green? Can you smell? Okay, I'm going to add frankincense and myrrh. Oops, thought it was. Essential oils. Stir, stir, stir. I want more lemon in this, too. I really want it lemony. I do this, I don't want it lemony. One thing is, when I make my products, man, I make them smell nice, and I don't cheapskate on the oils. I mean, I buy very high quality, high grade oils from all over the world, I have suppliers that I have spent hundreds and hundreds of dollars ordering product from them and found a few that I was absolutely disappointed in whatsoever. Until I found the suppliers that have the best products. Because what's the point of doing this if you're just going to cheap out and use cheap stuff? Okay, this I'm going to do in lavender. Out of the way. And grab the sponge. Clean up my area real quick. Cleanliness is next to godliness, isn't that what they always say? Clean that better later when I'm finished making these. If you need more coffee, bring me your cup. Get a sip of coffee real quick. Stay there or you'll be on TV. Been some coffee. Okay, so now I'm going to spray a little bit of the rubbing alcohol just to make sure that it doesn't dry out because we want it kind of on the wet side. Not soupy wet, but damp, very damp wet. I'm going to use this size tonight, my bigger size. Spray it with rubbing alcohol, disinfect. Wipe it out. I always wash these after I make bath bombs, but it sits in my storage room, and so I always want to spray it with rubbing alcohol to disinfect it. Whoops! We're going to disinfect that again, aren't we? wipe it out. Okay. Got that done. So we're gonna take, first I wanna put something pretty in it. Since these are gonna be yellow, I'm gonna take little pretty candies, and they look like they're candy flowers. Can you see that? And I'm gonna put it upside down in the bottom of the bath bomb mold. Then I'm gonna sprinkle the mixture. Set that in there. And if I get this open, we'll use some glitter candy sugar in the other end. These are always so tricky to get open. I guess I should have opened this before I did the video. Let me get scissors. Sprinkle a little of this in the bottom. And then we'll fill the other half. And when you fill them, you don't want to, I do not smash them into the mold. I make them like mounds, like a hill. Can you see that? And then you fold them together and squeeze it. Don't twist it. Squeeze it straight on. Off my mold, and then I, you see that? And I'll get a cookie sheet right here. And let's hope that this holds together. It's like a crapshoot sometimes. You see the flour that we put in there? I'm gonna put more in here because doesn't look like it held very good, the glitter. I'm gonna squeeze. That's better. And we'll set it right there. We'll get another little candy flower. Put it upside down, face down, in the middle. Put some yellow, some pretty green. I'll take the other one, and I've got little bunny rabbit candies. Again, I gotta use the scissors, sorry guys. Okay. And we'll put some of these in the bottom. Four. And then put some purple and some white. We'll bring these halves together. I'm going to do it over the white. Squish straight on. Really hard. Don't twist it. Just squeeze. And then once again, I want to move this over until I need it to this counter because I need a place to whack. That helps it release. Bath bombs are messy, so we've got the little rabbit candies in the end, and the flower. See that? Now we're gonna put it over here on the tray, and I'll show you the tray when we're all done making these, because there's no point in me swerving the camera back and forth. Okay. Get some more little bunnies. A little bit of glitter to make it pretty. I love that eucalyptus and yellow lemon essential oil. Oh my goodness, that smells so wonderful. I wish you guys could smell it. Put a little of the green, a little of the purple, and then the other half, we'll put another flower, we'll put a yellow flower, put some yellow, some green, some white, and we'll put purple. That way when we smash them together, we won't get other colors in our bath bomb mixtures. Now we're going to put them together and squeeze straight on. Squeeze as hard as you can. Clean off your bath bomb mold, and we're going to go whack, 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 whack. There's the bottom, flip it over, and there's that bottom with the yellow, can you see it? The yellow flower, and that's with the candy sugar. Oops, my candy sugar, my candy flower came out, so I'm going to put this back in the mold, add some more, put it back in the mold. And I'm going to squeeze to compact it even more. Not real super strong in the arms, so I have to use the counter. Let's see if that helped at all. Okay. Put that on the tray. And let's see, let's do another flower. Put a little bit in the bottom first. Put the flower, a little bit of yellow, a little bit of green or greenish blue, a little bit of purple, some white. Set that down here, that half. And we'll get some of these candies. Put them in the bottom, just like that. Do a little yellow, do a little bluey green, a little purple, and white. Two halves together, squeeze, we need the counter to squeeze, get ready for the bang, 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 bang. See? If you can see all the varied layers of the pretty pastel colors. Okay, when I get them all made, I'll bring you back. And something else I'm going to be doing with, after I get done making the bath balls, I'm going to be making bath bombs and putting them in these little paper cups, smooshing them in there, and then I can make cupcake bath bombs. So I'll bring you back when I get those done. Hey guys, I'm back. I wanted to show you the finished product, and I'm going to move in here so that you can get a good look at them. Here's all. I got a full cookie sheet, and then I got three of the cupcake cups. And they smell absolutely divine. Oh, I wish we had smell-o-vision or smell-o-monitor. So I hope this helps you guys to be able to try cupcakes, or to try to make bath bombs and bath bomb cupcakes. That's what I was trying to say. Thanks for joining me. See you again next video.